Introducing NVK Loopmaker 2. This is a Reaper script designed to make seamless sound effect loops for video games and other applications. With version 2, it's been rewritten from the ground up with a responsive UI, loop preview, and a number of other improvements. Let's take a look at what's possible with this script. First, select the item you want to create a loop with. Then, run the script. A loop will be automatically created from the selected item. You can then preview the loop by pressing the spacebar. If that's all you need and you don't need to make any adjustments, you can press enter or click apply and you are done. Now you have a seamless loop ready to be imported into your game engine. While the default settings work for a lot of cases, you may want to make some adjustments. At the top of the window, you have the glue button. With this enabled, the loop will be glued on export to make it easy to render or move around in your project. And below that, you have the loop slider. This splits the item into multiple loops, but with crossfade points that allow them to blend together seamlessly. Now you can have these loops play in any order in the game engine and they will still sound good. Let's export these loops and add them to WISE as a random container to see how they sound. We can set it to continuous loop with sample accurate transitions. Now with the sounds in this container, when we play it back, it will randomly choose one of the loops to play. If your loop is mostly noise-based content, you might add some pitch modulation to the container for even more variation. This is a great way to add infinite variation to your loop with less memory usage than if you were to just have one long loop. With Loopmaker, you can also get the same effect in Reaper. Let's say you have a 10-second loop, but you need to cover a 60-second scene. Make a time selection that is 60 seconds long and run the script with your item selected. The loop will be automatically duplicated to fit the time selection. Now if we increase the number of loops, we have variations that can be shuffled around for a less repetitive loop. And with the Shuffle Variation Positions button, this will be done automatically for you. If you have multiple loops, you can choose to space out the variations so they are separated in your project. You can also loop multiple items at once. Let's select four different layers we want to make into a single loop. The script will make each item into a loop, and with the checkbox Match Length of Overlapping Items, it will make the loops the same length as the shortest item. If you need the loop to be longer and are okay with some doubled content, you can instead make a time selection of the length you need. If we open up the crossfade section, there are some more options for how the loops are created. You can change the length percentage of the crossfade in order to get a smoother or more abrupt transition. You can also adjust the curve of the crossfade. Depending on the phase of the content, you may want to adjust this to get better volume consistency. Since the crossfade lengths are percentage-based, you may want to limit the max crossfade length so that longer loops don't have unnecessarily long crossfades. Sometimes you might find that the zero crossing of the loop isn't where you might want it to be. Now you can adjust where the zero crossing is with the offset slider. With a single loop, this doesn't tend to matter much, but with multiple loops, this will determine the content that is shared between the loops to make them blend together. Now you can target parts of the loop that won't stick out as much, which can give better results. You can also see here if a zero crossing was successfully found for each loop. In the name section, you can choose how the loop is colored and named. The color item setting makes it easy to differentiate between multiple loops. You can also choose to remove extensions, such as .wave, automatically. And if you want to add loop at the end of the name, you can type loop in the suffix box. There are options for separators and numbers as well. So if you're creating multiple loops, those can be numbered according to your naming scheme. Finally, let's take a look at the shepherd tone section. When you open this section, Loopmaker will change into shepherd tone mode. A shepherd tone is a sound that appears to continually rise or fall in pitch forever. This is achieved with a constant crossfade between two tones at different pitches. The length of the resulting loop will always be a ratio of the original length. The pitch slider determines the direction and the amount of the pitch change. Changing the number of loops will add more layers to the shepherd tone, enhancing its effect. This mode is quite experimental, so just play around with it and see what you can come up with. So that's a quick look at NVK Loopmaker 2. I hope you find it useful. Thanks for watching.